You ask, how do I get my ex back? You ask, how do I move on? And you say you will do anything to get your ex back. Yet, most of you won't do the one thing that will actually achieve that. No contact will either get your ex back or it will help you move on. Either way, it will always work and it will always be a win-win. And let's be real. What fucking choice do you actually have? This is The Love Fix, and if you're new here, my name is Nick, and I give relationship and breakup advice that doesn't suck. Love Advice TV. If you need my help with getting through your personal breakup situation, or you just want me to tell you how much of a dickhead your ex is, hit the coaching link in the description and book your one-to-one call with me. If that is not enough, come and join the wonderful Facebook group by also hitting the other link in the description. You can't miss it. It says Facebook. I'm smart like that. If you are the dumpee and you're constantly breaking no contact, begging, pleading for your ex to come back, your actions tell me you are needy and desperate. You probably feel attacked after I've said that, but if I can pick up on it, your ex most certainly can. After all, nothing communicates confidence and self-esteem and validation more than constantly harassing someone who has politely told you to fuck off. If you didn't quite pick up on my sarcasm there, your ex dumping you isn't code for try harder and contact them 10 times more than you did when you were together. Okay, I'm being a dick in this video and I am starting to understand why it takes so long for my subscriber count to go up, but I'd rather you hate me and get well over you liking me and staying sick. You could of course write a handwritten letter to your ex, because nothing says I'm desperate more than you telling your ex how pathetic you are. Love Advice TV. It's 2023, guys. We have WhatsApp. You bunch of troglodytes.
Something magical about writing a letter, a handwritten letter, to someone you love.
Coming from the people who charge $277 for a 30-minute coaching call and a tailored game plan. How's this for a crazy idea? Write the letter and fucking burn it, because the accountability part should have already happened during the breakup conversation. And just an FYI, I do 1-hour coaching calls for significantly less than Love Advice TV. Hit the coaching link in the description. Shameless plug. No contact is going to suck, regardless if it brings your ex back, or God forbid, you may just move on to someone better and realize what a fuckhead your ex is. You must do the shit that will hurt you today to give you the result you want tomorrow. No contact is the story of you loving yourself more than your ex and your desire to get them back. This, ironically, well, not ironically, it's actually pretty fucking obvious to do the thing you don't want to do, because life sucks most of the time and we have to do hard shit to get the good shit that we want. Moving on. If you're still with me, you're a fucking legend. Coach Lee would have advertised his ex-back program by now. I don't have an ex-back program. I have a get you back and tell your ex to fuck off program. But should you be curious about Coach Lee's ex-back program, spoiler alert, just do no contact. Your silence will speak louder than words ever could, and it will speak louder than
something magical about writing a letter, a handwritten letter, to someone you love.
1 million subscribers, here I fucking come with that skillful piece of editing. No contact is a response. It is communication. You're telling your ex you will be just fine with or without them. You're telling your ex you heard them and you are respecting their wishes. You're telling your ex if they don't come back, it's not your preferred outcome, but you will move on just fine. That, my friends, is the sexy response. No contact is for you and to get you back. Let's call it a detox, for lack of a better term. Ugh, I feel dirty for saying that because it's total bullshit, but YouTube algorithm and all that, you know, I've got to pay the bills. No contact is your only move when going through a breakup. Every natural instinct in your body is telling you to do something to get something, because that is how the rest of the world works. Work hard to get more money and promoted, do your homework to get good grades and so on. For just once in your life, you must do the things you don't want to do to achieve the outcome you want. I don't like keeping my calories under control, but I don't want bitch tits at the same time. I therefore must do things I need to do for the things I want to get. And guys, I've been the fat kid. The bitch tits were not sexy. Give your ex the mystery. Give them thinking, what the fuck are you up to? And let them dwell on why you're not reaching out. You're not reaching out because you're not here to fit into their reality. You're here to build your own reality and to build your own purpose. That is the sexiest thing you can do to help get them back. It's most definitely the sexiest thing you can do for yourself as well. The least sexy thing you can do is
something magical about writing a letter, a handwritten letter, to someone you love.
And that's all I've got for today. If you like this video, great. If not, tell someone who cares. My name is Nick. This is The Love Fix. You are going to be okay. You will be fine, I promise. Just do the work. And for the love of all things good and holy, do not write a handwritten letter. It won't work. Write it and burn it. Or use it for toilet paper. I don't care. Just don't do it. That's all I've got for today. You are enough. And I will see you on the other side.